Welcome students. Today we are discuss the transmission media and we discuss the topic unguided media. So unguided media is also known as a wireless media and it is also known as a unbound transmission media. Unguided media are transport the electromagnetic waves without using any physical conductor. The signal are normally broadcast through air and thus are available to anyone who has a device capable to receiving them. Unguided transmission media are the way of transmitting the data without any using cable. These media are not bounded by the physical geography. These types of transmission media is called wireless communication. Some popular example of the unguided transmission media are microwave and radio wave. Unguided media transport the electromagnetic waves without using any physical conductor. These types of communication is often referred as a wireless communication. The characteristic of this media make them good alternative situations where it difficult or impossible to use the cable. As shown in figure, the electromagnetic spectrum unguided media is ranging from 3 kHz to 900 terahertz. So as shown in figure, our radio wave spectrum is 3 kHz to 900 terahertz. Unguided media broadly classify into the following four category: radio wave, microwave, infrared and laser. Unguided signal can travel from source to destination in several ways. There is a ground propagation, sky propagation, line of sight propagation. Now ground propagation. In this propagation, the radio wave travels through the lowest portion of the atmosphere, hanging the earth, and the low frequency signal emanate in all the direction from the transmitting antenna and follow the curvature of planet. The distance depends on the amount of power and the greater the distance. This is a ground wave propagation and through which we propagate the signal which is the frequency below the 2 MHz. Sky propagation. In this propagation, the higher frequency radio wave radiate upper into the ionosphere, the layer of the atmosphere where the particles exit as the ions, where they are reflected back to the earth. These types of transmission media allow for the greater distance with low power output. So we transmit such a way signals through the sky wave propagation. The frequency is between the 2 MHz to 30 MHz. Line of sight propagation. In this propagation, very high frequency signal are transmitted in a straight line direct from antenna to antenna. The antenna must be directional, facing each other and either tall enough, close enough together, not to be affected by the curvature of the earth. Line of sight propagation is strictly because the radio transmission cannot be completely focused. And we transmit the such a way signals through the line of sight propagation. The frequency is above 30 MHz. Radio wave. The radio wave are electromagnetic waves occurring on a radio frequency portion of the electromagnetic spectrum. A common use is used to transport the information through the atmosphere or outer space without wire. Radio wave are differ from the other kind of electromagnetic waves by their wavelength, a relatively long wavelength in an electromagnetic spectrum. Although there is no clear-cut differentiation between the radio wave and microwave, the electromagnetic waves ranging from frequency between the 3 kHz to 1 GHz are normally called the radio wave.
Radio wave are easy to generate, can travel a long distance and penetrate the building easily too, so they are widely used in a communication both indoor as well as outdoor. Radio wave are also omnidirectional, meaning that they are travel in all the direction from the source, so that transmitter and receiver do not have to be carefully aligned physically. Radio wave propagate in the sky wave mode. Advantage of the radio wave. Radio wave are particularly those wave that propagate in the sky mode can travel long distance. For example, AM radio. Radio wave, particularly those of low and medium frequency, can propagate wall, so they are widely used for communication, both indoor as well as outdoor. Radio wave are also omnidirectional. When an antenna transmits radio wave, they are propagate in all the direction. This means that sending and receiving the antenna do not have to be aligned. A sending antenna can send the wave that can be received by the receiving antenna. Disadvantage of the radio wave. Radio wave are also omnidirectional, meaning that they are travel in all the direction from the source. The radio wave transmitted by the one antenna are susceptible to interface by the another antenna that may be send the signal using same frequency or band. Radio wave can penetrate the wall, so we cannot isolate a communication to just inside or outside a building. The radio wave band is relatively narrow, just under the 1 gigahertz compared to the microwave band. So when this band is divided into the sub-band, the side band are also narrow, leading to the low data rate for the digital communication. Application of the radio wave. The omnidirectional characteristic of the radio wave make them useful for multicasting, in which there is a one sender but many receiver, AM, FM radio, television broadcasting, cordless phone, paging, GPS receiver, police radio, wireless clock, etc. Microwave, electromagnetic wave having the frequency between the 1 gigahertz to 300 gigahertz is called the microwave. Microwave are unidirectional. When the antenna is transmit microwave, they can be narrow focus. This means that the sending and receiving antenna need to be aligned without interfering with another pair of the aligned antenna. Microwave use the line of sight propagation. Advantage of the microwave. Microwave are unidirectional. Sending and receiving the antenna need to be aligned, so they are not interfering with another pair of the aligned antenna. The microwave band is relatively wider compared to the radio wave band. When this band is divided into the sub-band, the side band are also wider, leading to the higher data rate for digital communication. Microwave are relatively inexpensive and simple to install. Disadvantage of the microwave. The microwave travel in a straight line. If the tower are too far apart, and the earth will get in the way. Co-sequentially repeater are often needed for long distance communication periodically. Second, very high frequency microwave cannot be penetrate the wall, so it's disadvantage if it is received inside the building. Application of the microwave. The unidirectional characteristic of the microwave make them useful for unicasting, in which there is a one sender and one receiver, cellular phone, satellite network, wireless LAN, infrared. Electromagnetic wave having the frequency from 300 gigahertz to 400 terahertz is called the infrared. Infrared wave are widely used for short-range communication. The remote control used in a television, VCR, stereo, all are used in a infrared communication. Infrared wave are line-of-sight propagation. Advantage of the infrared. Infrared wave are relatively directional, cheap, and easy to build. Infrared wave having the high frequency, so they are not able to penetrate the wall. So the infrared system in a one room will not interfere with the similar system adjust room. Infrared wave are useful for short range communication. It is more secure against the tapping. It is useful to communicate wireless keyboard, mouse with the PC by using the infrared port. Disadvantage of infrared wave. Infrared wave are useless for long-range communication. They do not pass from the solid object. We cannot use the infrared wave outside the building because the sun ray consists the infrared that can interfere with the communication. Application of the infrared wave. The remote control used in a television, VCR, stereo are based on the infrared. Short-range wireless communication, wireless keyboard, mouse in PC by using the infrared port. Used in military such as a target acquisition, surveillance, homing and tracking. Used in a thermal efficiency analysis, room temperature sensing, spectroscopy and weather forecasting. Laser. The full name of the laser is light amplification by the stimulated emission of radiation. High power laser transmitted can transmit the data for several thousand yard when line of sight communication is possible. Laser can use in a many of same situation as a microwave link without requiring an FC license. On the land, laser light technology is similar to the infrared technology. The laser communication system are wireless connection through the atmosphere. They work similar to the fiber optics link. Expect the beam is transmitted through the free space. The laser communication system can easily deployed since they are inexpensive, small and low power and do not require to radio wave interference. The carrier used in a signal transmission signal is typically generated by the laser diode. Two parallel beam are needed, one for transmission and another for reception. The basic field of the application for laser data transmission is implementation of the short distance and high bandwidth link. Thank you.